Hello and welcome to the session on Jacinto 7 software training. In this session, we will learn how to build gateway applications on the Jacinto 7 platform using the Prosser SDK automotive release. We will look at some of the key features required for gateway applications and how they are enabled using the Prosser SDK. We will start with the typical hardware block diagram for a gateway system and its intended mapping to Jacinto 7 platform. Next, we will look at the overall software architecture for developing gateway applications on the Jacinto 7 platform. As part of this, we will look at the various SDK components and details of how they are deployed on the Jacinto 7 platform. We will then look at how to build and run the two gateway-centric demos that are included as part of the Prosser SDK, the CAN Ethernet bridging application and the Ethernet traffic routing filtering applications. My name is Sriram. I am the software architect for Prosser SDK. Let us start with the hardware block diagram for a gateway system. Gateway systems are primarily responsible for in-vehicle data movement. Fast startup time is a critical feature for gateway systems. To enable fast boot-up time, a high-speed OSPI NOR flash interface is used for bootstrapping the system. Typical gateway systems also include an external safety MCU for running safety-critical applications. Jacinto 7 platform integrates safety MCU island on-chip that can be used for running safety applications. Gateway systems need to handle CAN traffic from multiple CAN nodes in the vehicle network. The connection to multiple CAN nodes is represented as CAN array in the hardware block diagram. CAN-FT modules from the safety MCU island and the main domain can be used for this purpose. We are also witnessing Ethernet being adopted as a high bandwidth network backbone for communications inside a car. Gateway systems play a key role in providing intra-domain and inter-domain high bandwidth connectivity over Ethernet. Often this requires capabilities for packet inspection, forwarding, and filtering. On the Jacinto 7 platform, the one-port Ethernet from the safety MCU island and the integrated Ethernet switch from the main domain can be used for this purpose. The integrated Ethernet switch on Jacinto 7 platform includes several hardware offload features for inter-VLAN routing, packet filtering, and rate limiting that can be effectively leveraged. We then have the LIN array that can be connected to the UART modules on the Jacinto 7 platform. Traffic bridging between CAN, Ethernet, and LIN interfaces can be offloaded to firmware running on a real-time processing core. This can be one of the R5 instances in the safety MCU island or from the main domain. Additional devices that need to be connected to the Jacinto 7 platform would include the LPDDR module for runtime code and data storage, PMIC for power management, and eMMC for higher density non-volatile storage. For higher storage needs and faster access, an NVMe SSD disk can potentially be interfaced over PCIe. We will now take a closer look at how the functionality required for the gateway application can be mapped to the various peripheral subsystems and processing blocks available on the Jacinto 7 platform. To start with, the CAN-FT modules on the Jacinto 7 platform are used to send and receive CAN traffic. There are two such instances in the safety MCU domain and several CAN-FT instances in the main domain. Ethernet traffic is handled through multi-port integrated Ethernet switch and through an additional single-port Ethernet module in the MCU domain. For the CAN Ethernet bridging application, we leverage the DMA data movement capabilities provided by the Jacinto 7 platform to efficiently handle this from a real-time R5F core. Runtime statistics like the bridging latency and CPU load information are reported over the UART console. Ethernet firmware running on one of the main domain R5 core handles the switch configuration and provides the interface for dynamic switch configuration management. The integrated Ethernet switch includes a number of hardware blocks that can be used for packet inspection, classification, and filtering. These can be leveraged for a number of purposes, including steering of traffic to multiple CPU cores on the Jacinto 7 platform, traffic filtering and rate limiting using the layer 2, layer 3 header fields, hardware offload for inter-VLAN routing. If further processing of packet stream is required, the traffic can be steered into one or more hardware queues for inspection from the A72 cores. This feature, along with the hardware policer block, can be used to implement firewall and intrusion detection system on the A72 core. Time synchronization is supported using a dedicated hardware timestamping module. Additional applications like precision time protocol for time synchronization, software-based routing, can be run from the R5F core, thereby completely offloading the A72 cores. These can be run from the same R5F core that hosts the switch firmware. CAN Ethernet bridging application can be run from the MCU domain R5 instance or from the main domain. In the current SDK implementation, the application is hosted on the MCU domain R5F instance. Let us now see how the various functional blocks map to the components from the SDK. Jacinto 7 platform is built on a heterogeneous architecture that includes a mix of real-time CPU cores, generic compute cores, and the integrated safety MCU island for safety applications. Software running on multiple cores collaborate with each other to realize overall system function. We will now look at the various software components for the gateway application and their mapping to the various cores. We take a two-pronged approach. We first review the software mapping as it is enabled with the current processor SDK, and then the more optimized mapping, which we will cover as part of future SDK releases. For the standalone gateway application, the DSP cores and the MCU3 R5F cores are typically not used. Execution starts with the bootloader running from the MCU domain R5F. R5F uboot is used for bootstrapping the other cores in the system. SBL or TA's bare metal bootloader is used for bootstrapping the MCU domain firmware, including the CAN Ethernet bridging application. These are mutually exclusive in the current SDK release, but future releases will migrate to an unified boot flow of using SBL to bootstrap both the MCU domain and the other cores in the system. Then the operating system is brought up on the respective cores. TI RTOS is brought up on the R5F cores in the MCU and the main domain. On A72 cores, initially uboot is loaded, which in turn bootstraps the Linux kernel. Linux kernel loads the jailhouse hypervisor. Communication between software running on multiple cores is enabled through the IPC library on each core. In the MCU domain, the CAN Ethernet application is built on top of the MCAL implementation. MCAL layer allows for integration into the AUTOSAR stack. Current SDK implementation of the CAN Ethernet bridging application uses the two CAN instances and the one port Ethernet from the MCU domain. MCU20R5F in the main domain hosts the firmware for the integrated Ethernet switch. The Ethernet switch firmware provides the necessary interface for configuration of the switch, which is used by the demo application that illustrates the Ethernet switch filtering and routing capabilities. MCU21R5F is currently unused and can be used for hosting customer applications. On the A72 side, Linux kernel includes support for storage drivers like eMMC and NVMe SSD. Linux SDK also includes a virtual Ethernet driver that can be used for direct packet transmission and reception from the A72 core. Network stack comprising of TCP/IP and other layers is integrated on all cores, including the R5F that hosts the Ethernet switch firmware. Additional applications like firewalling and intrusion detection systems can be implemented on the A72 cores running Linux. Security and safety considerations might drive need for additional virtual machine-based sandboxing. In such cases, additional VM instances can be run on top of the hypervisor. Applications like firmware over the air update can then be deployed under a separate VM instance. We will now switch to the intended software mapping view. This represents a more complete and optimized mapping for the gateway application. In this case, the execution starts with the AUTOSAR or SBL bootloader, which in turn bootstraps the rest of the cores in the system. Then the R5F cores in the MCU domain and the MCU20R5 instance in the main domain are initialized. These can potentially run AUTOSAR OS while Linux is bootstrapped on the A72 cores. In the MCU domain, AUTOSAR IPC and MCAL components allow for integration with the AUTOSAR stack. The CAN Ethernet bridging application is now migrated to run from the main domain R5F. The MCU domain R5F is completely free for integration of customer applications. MCU21R5F instance in the main domain is dedicated for running the HSM SHI stack. This in turn can be used for offloading crypto operations from software running in the MCU domain and from the MCU20R5F instance. On the MCU20R5F, the Ethernet switch firmware and applications are now run from the AUTOSAR context. The CAN Ethernet bridging application will now handle traffic from the CAN instances and Ethernet ports in both the MCU and the main domains. On the A72 course, we continue to host multiple virtual machines with the intended applications as before. Now let us turn our attention to the example demos that are included in the SDK package. SDK includes two demos that are intended for gateway systems. You can navigate to these from the top level RTAS SDK user guide getting started link. Ethernet switch demonstration of features such as the packet filtering and routing are described under the Ethernet firmware section. The CAN Ethernet bridging application is described under the Gateways demo section. Click on the Gateways demo link to get started. This will take you to the CAN Ethernet Gateway demo page. This page has information about the CAN Ethernet bridging demo, including a brief description of the demo, hardware setup details, dependencies, and instructions on how to build and run the demo. Similarly, you can navigate to the Ethernet switch demo following links from the RTOS SDK user guide. This will take you to the Ethernet firmware user guide page. Under the Ethernet firmware user guide page, navigate down to the Ethernet firmware demo application section. This page describes the various Ethernet switch hardware features that are illustrated in the demo, dependencies, and steps for running the demo. Switch demonstration relies on a GUI-based tool for runtime switch configuration, which is also duly described under this page. Shown here is a system block diagram for CAN Ethernet bridging application. CAN Ethernet bridging application runs on the MCU domain R5F instance. CAN Ethernet bridging application is built on top of MCAL drivers for CAN and Ethernet modules. Bridging application is realized as a periodic polling task that services CAN and Ethernet packet queues that are independently populated by their respective drivers. The bridging application uses IEEE 1722 based encapsulation for moving CAN packets over Ethernet. The hardware setup diagram describes the external connections for the demo. Two CAN instances from the MCU domain are used, and traffic is initiated from a PC host that uses the PCAN module for sending and receiving CAN frames. Ethernet port from the MCU domain is connected to a Linux PC, where the host application for sending and receiving Ethernet frames is run. The application demonstrates full duplex bridging between CAN Ethernet and CAN CAN modules. For the Ethernet switch demonstration, the software consists of Ethernet switch firmware running on the MCU20 R5F instance. Alongside this, we will also use the virtual Ethernet driver running on the A72 core and optionally a client driver running from the MCU21F R5F instance. These communicate with the Ethernet switch firmware for the switch configuration. Once set up, the virtual driver from A72 and the client driver from MCU21 R5F can directly send or receive packets. We then have the network stack on top of the driver. The filtering and the routing application sits on top of the Ethernet firmware directly. We then exercise the multiple applications like iPerf, web server, media streaming using Plex as part of the demonstration to showcase the data forwarding and filtering capabilities of the Ethernet switch. Hardware setup diagram describes the external connections needed for the demo. External connectivity is through two of the gigabit Ethernet ports on the gateway expansion card of the EVM. These connect to two independent Linux PCs that are used to generate or capture the network traffic. We now look at how to build and run the CAN Ethernet bridging application demonstration. Pre-built binaries for the CAN Ethernet bridging application is not packaged as part of the SDK, and this must be specifically built from the source files that are included as part of the SDK. Start by navigating to the Building the Demo section of the CAN Ethernet Gateway Demo user guide. CAN Ethernet bridging application uses a simple makefile-based build approach for building the demo application and any required PC-side tools. Ensure that the tool paths are correctly updated before you initiate your build. You can refer to the rules.make under the PDK component for reference. Once built, the application and the host-side tools will be placed under binary and PC tool subfolders respectively. To run the demos, we need to follow instructions from the user guide for the hardware setup and additional host side tools that are required. Once the hardware and the host tools are set up, follow instructions from the user guide for preparing an SD card with the bootloader, system firmware binary, and the CAN Ethernet bridging application binaries. Now boot the EVM in the SD card boot mode and follow instructions from the user guide for running the demo. The CAN Ethernet bridging demo runs as a standalone application from the MCU domain. In this demonstration, the other cores in the system are not bootstrapped. We will now look at the steps required for running the Ethernet switch demo. The Ethernet switch demo application is built along with the Ethernet switch firmware. Pre-built binaries for the Ethernet switch application are included as part of the Processor SDK Linux package. These can be used for a quick out-of-the-box demonstration. To run the demo, start by following instructions described under the Hardware Setup section of the Ethernet firmware user guide. You can get to this page from the Getting Started section of the RTOS SDK documentation. You will need the base EVM and the gateway expansion card for this demonstration. Once the hardware setup is done, navigate to the Ethernet firmware demo application section of the firmware user guide. This section describes the host side tool setup and instructions for running the demo. Ensure that the required host side tools are downloaded and installed on the Linux host PC that will be used with this demo. The list of the tools and instructions for setting them up are described under the demo setup section. Once the hardware and the host tools are set up, prepare an SD card with the required firmware images. We can then use the SD card boot mode of the EVM to launch the demo. For running the demo, we also need to use the GUI-based switch configuration tool to set up rules for packet forwarding and filtering. The demo application exercises a number of features of the integrated Ethernet switch. Follow the step-by-step instructions described in the user guide for running each of these sub-demos. For rebuilding the application along with the Ethernet firmware, follow instructions described under the build section of the Ethernet switch firmware user guide. Thanks for listening to this training session on how to build gateway applications using Processor SDK on Jacinto 7 platform. As part of this session, we reviewed a typical hardware block diagram for a gateway system. We learned how we can leverage the Jacinto 7 platform capabilities for building gateway applications. We also looked at reference software architecture for a gateway system and how it can be realized using the various SDK components running on the multiple heterogeneous cores on the Jacinto 7 platform. We then looked at the system design for two gateway-centric applications, the CAN Ethernet bridging application and the Ethernet traffic filtering and routing application. We also looked at where to find these in the Processor SDK and detailed steps for building and running these demos. If you need any further information, refer to the Processor SDK documentation. This is included as part of the SDK package itself and can also be accessed from ti.com. For any further clarifications and assistance, you can use the E2E forum for posting your queries.